This is a Rank Sentimentalist, and this is part 5 of our playthrough, or a let's play rather, on the American Civil War Brothers vs. Brothers mod for Empire Total War. The old mod team, there are some people that has kind of morphed, I guess. They have some new people on it, and this is the newest, the 3.5 beta with the Zone of Recruitment, which, just to recap, allows you to recruit a lot of unique units that anywhere that has a, and some of the units are recruited from special buildings at the through the regional command and military district and whatnot. But other units are available through the farms, and I think this is really neat. So the farms in every region allow you to recruit volunteers. And my army here is made up of Virginia volunteers. But onward. So I said last time we fought the Battle of Jackson, just north of Jackson, Mississippi here. We beat back a smaller Union force, but one that was commanded by a general, by General Buford, who survived the battle and sent them scurrying back across the Mississippi. They have another army that looks like it's headed down towards Louisiana. So what we're going to do, we're recruiting 3 units of Louisiana volunteers. And out west here, we are at war with Mexico, but we have not seen any Mexican army. Still, we have a good-sized force of Texas volunteers, some artillery and some cavalry, ready to deal with any Mexican army that we see. There are still no generals ready for recruitment besides General Lee, so hopefully we'll get one of those next turn. But we are blockaded by the Union here. We are not going to attack with our Army of Northern Virginia here until we get those 2 units of cavalry recruited. And even then, we might need to recruit some more troops. When these troops from Georgia, South Carolina, and North Carolina arrive to fight with the armies. We'll have 5 additional units in that army and can probably get a little more offensive. Okay, so we're going to end the turn right here and hope that this army doesn't just march down and attack New Orleans. We're going to fight this out. Thank you. So this could be pretty interesting here, actually. Oh, actually, what we should do... Yes, because they'll have to cross the fence. And even after they get across the fence, they'll have to deal with our artillery. Okay, let's see what happens. This could actually be pretty interesting because their cavalry has to come across that fence. We've got poor forces with us. But those three cavalry units could break instantly. Another Iron Brigade unit. But all this cavalry could theoretically be routed already by the time those guys even get up here. So this would be pretty interesting. Washington artillery. Yeah, when the cavalry tries to cross this fence, they're gonna get hammered by canister shot and a lot of musket fire. Thank you. they got it going on because their fire rate must be fairly. Their reload. 35. We'll have to check that against our other artillery. They're pumping out the rounds here. Canister shot. Oh, this is not going to be good. Oh, yeah, wavering. Shattered. Canister shot against these guys. Wavering. So yeah, that... Oh God, they didn't even make it to the fence. As Rod Steiger says in the Waterloo movie, waste of damn fine cavalry. They would get cutesy by sending all this cavalry in, and it did not work to their advantage. Shatter. Oh, they go right there. But that was kind of an interesting strategy on the part of the Union to send their cavalry. Never seen that happen. I've, you know, played a couple of these campaigns before doing this Let's Play. So many beautiful horses. I was watching something on the History Channel the other day. Was it the rebels had taken down that fence at Pickett's Charge, like stop and take the fence down? They would have won the Battle of Gettysburg. They all just climbed over the fence. coming forward. This is the Union Iron Brigade. They're running. It's a long way to run. They're gonna be exhausted. And they still have a ways to go. We might have after this battle is just the remnants of this army running around playing, grab ass, raiding, and things of that nature. So, the moment of truth is when they get to this fence up here. Yeah, it was interesting. That second unit of cavalry seemed to come right out of the cannon smoke. From my perspective, where I was sitting back. And I installed the smoke light mod, actually. They're getting towards the fence. Switch to canister shot. That was pretty crazy. We had some fog of war type situations there. And let's see where that army goes. Hopefully all the way back across the Mississippi. Mexican army here on the border. No Union threat. So, still no generals available. Three units of Louisiana volunteers. They're just going to hang out there. We don't need to any more of those. And that army can probably go down there and smash those guys. here we seem to be good. Four, 4, 8, 6.
Sure. Make ready. Humble soul. Forward! What? Slaughter them!
So let's have Georgia, South Carolina, North Carolina. A rainy day. I don't think we're even going to really do anything with our army here, except for set up our artillery, maybe. Let's have General Lee, get back there and relax. So we're depending on these guys to fight the battle. South Carolina has kind of the lowest morale, so we're going to put them in the center. And we'll have our two stronger units on the wings on both sides supporting them. But we have a pretty good advantage here, so it should be over relatively quickly, I would think. Thank you. These guys are all very well equipped. With all of their, what do they call those, forage caps? Someone correct me if I'm wrong. Please. As you see, Georgia, South Carolina, and North Carolina have a much more, it's like more of like a ragtag look. Yeah, these log obstacles are really pretty bad to the bone because they have to go around them. Slows them down. Well, let's see what's going on here. Hopefully these two units will be able to, they're up to the task. And we want to kind of want to totally destroy this unit, just so we don't have to deal with it. Running around down here raiding farms, so if if they break, we're going to let them have it with our cavalry. So we've gone into Ranger file here, and yeah, New Jersey Volunteers are hanging on pretty good. Had enough. But yeah, we need to basically totally destroy this unit. freezing rain. It's like the worst day of the year to be fighting a battle. Okay, so, yep, we took care of that raiding force, which is good. So we will repair that plantation.
At the ready.
They've gone as far as they could, but we will start replenishing them. And next time, we will fight... first battle of Woodstock, we'll call it. That is right around where, I don't know, Manassas is, isn't it? Anyway, see you next time.